Well, what can I say, guys? Of course, I am a Tottenham fan, but my Italian team is Inter Milan, and it always has been. And I've got stories to tell you about this jersey, actually, and where I got it from. But first, here's the intro. Roll the intro. Ba-ba-da-ba. Again, I'm Luisi21, also known as John Luca Luisi. We're back, guys, and I just want to tell you a little story about this jersey and where I got it and what it means and how the whole Mourinho thing has come full circle and how the teams I love dearly, both of them, have had Mourinho at different stages in the last 10 years. Amazing, I can't believe it. Like, think about it, he's been in so many different jobs over the last 20 years. Let alone since Inter Milan. And a lot of people say there's a post and a pre-Madrid Mourinho. And yeah, he's different, he's just learnt more. And of course, second spell at Chelsea, he got a lot of criticism, and at United, they just hated him, yeah. And he didn't really, he got second and got Europa League, so it's not like he didn't do anything or win anything in that sense. But yeah, this jersey, I got this in 2009, back in the day, when I was like, I don't know, my view on football was different to how it is now. My level of passion just increased since then. Obviously started with the 06 World Cup when Italy won. From there I just started loving football a lot more than I ever did, or taking notice of football a lot more. So yeah, this jersey I got in Milan in 2009 actually, and at the time Inter had Mourinho. And they were winning the league year in, year out, you know, winning games week in, week out. And, you know, at the time, who would have thought they'd win the Champions League that year, 2010. But yeah, this was 09, around New Year's time, we went to Milan. Big family holiday, like maybe a week. And so one could say I entered the noughties in Milan. I was in Italy, basically. And yeah, I was in the Inter store right near the Duomo in Milan, and I bought this jersey because I loved Inter. Of course, I already had Spurs jerseys, loads of them. I was already an avid Spurs fan, obviously, but Inter as well. I support them for the same reasons, because they're not like any other club, you know, quite unique in their ways. And of course, my favourite player at the time was Zanetti, not to mention Eto, you know, Milito, Schneider, all the other great legends that were there, you know. But Zanetti was the guy I supported. He was the captain, fantastic. He was a legendary player, could play left back, right back, left mid, right mid, centre mid, centre back, anywhere, apart from goal, really. So I thought, I better get this jersey, let me get this. I can't remember, I think one of my uncles got it for me. Got my name printed on the back with number 4. For Zanetti, of course, and at the time in Parma football, I was number 4. I had been for a long time because of Zanetti, and that's when the number really stuck. Of course, now I'm number 21 for Pirlo, another legend, but that's another story for another video. But yes, I bought this jersey, and I was lucky enough to see Inter Milan in maybe the quarterfinals or the semis, one of them anyway, against Chelsea. I think it was the quarterfinal against Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. So I've got a good friend of mine who's a Chelsea fan. Strangely, I'm a Spurs fan. Ironically, it's all surrounding Mourinho. So yeah, they're big fans of Mourinho at the time. He's at Inter and he's back at Stamford Bridge to play against them. And what does Mourinho do in the typical Mourinho style? He beats one of the teams he used to coach or be involved with, you know. It's some sort of memorable thing that he always seems to do. And that was just beyond belief. Like, you know, I was an away fan technically there, and I'm a Spurs fan, so it was great to see Chelsea lose and Inter beat them. And the fact that it was Mourinho, their ex-manager, doing it as well, just to rub the salt in the wounds, you know, that was even better. And that was like February. And then they went on the run, they beat Barcelona on the way to the final. He beat Guardiola's Barcelona. Think about that. I mean, that's why, where the rivalry started. And then you go to the final, the Bayern Munich, and Inter beat Louis van Gaal's Bayern Munich. A guy that Mourinho was translator for at Barcelona. Of course, before that was Bobby Robson, but yeah, so it was like the student beating the teacher in some ways, the master or whatever. I don't know, even though I would say Mourinho's probably a better manager nowadays. And yeah, so now, fast forward, what, 10 years, 9 years, Poch gets sacked, sadly, very sad to see him go, and Mourinho gets the Spurs job, which I never really could comprehend happening. I mean, I think it was just a power move, like, not a power move, but like a move from Levy to like, make sure we get Mourinho and sack Poch before Arsenal sacked Emre, which we did. And now they're stuck with Emre, so it's a win for Spurs, a double win. And we've got Chelsea's ex-boss, and we're gonna probably upset them at some point with Mourinho, because he loves upsetting his old teams. And we're gonna upset United, and we're gonna just annoy Guardiola and City, and Liverpool at some point. Hopefully. But it's early days, and this first season is Mourinho's grace period. But that has been my little story about my Inter Milan jersey and how Mourinho is connected to my football passion. Obviously, there's been times when I haven't been in favour of him, or, you know, of the other teams he's coached, or like the things he's done, but yeah, he's back. That's all I can say. He's back in the Prem. Actually doing well for now. But yeah, it's good times, good times. And of course Inter Milan won last night, 3-1 the Slavia Prague. They had VAR pulled it back for a penalty they gave away, and it was 1-1 at some point. Anyway, and then Spurs won the other night 4-2. You know, defence needs work, Mourinho. That's what I can say at the moment. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed my little story. And yeah, back to it for me. Enjoy whatever you're doing, enjoy your weekend. Take it easy as always, and just remember, tomorrow's never promised, so just, if you love football, keep enjoying it, you know? It's great. Apart from VAR, that we could all some days live without. I mean, when it helps you, it's fine. Take it easy, guys, and I'll see you real soon. Peace.